In May, we formed a search committee of five directors on the board to find the replacement for our president, Esther George.
Our search committee is really excited and very passionate about being included and being invited to serve in this capacity, because it's probably the most important thing that we can do, to go through this process and go through this process in a way that everybody feels like we have done a really great job.
That's a very important time for the Federal Reserve Bank. I mean, being on the search committee and trying to find the next president of the bank is a really, really heavy task. And I'm proud to be bringing my perspective as common working people.
So the next president of the KC Fed should really have a strong balance of both monetary policy and economics, but also organizational management and being able to run a large institution or organization.
Clearly you want somebody that's inclusive. You want somebody that has the culture and the values of the 10th district. You want somebody that's inquisitive. You want somebody that's questioning. You want somebody that is ethical. You want somebody that's trustworthy.
And one of the other things is the vast nature of the 10th district. It's the second largest geographical area of any of the banks, and it's over 500,000 square miles. And I know because I rode that motorcycle right there all over it.
It is extremely important for the Federal Reserve President to understand the economy that exists within our district. This economy includes mining, aerospace, agriculture.
But we also have some industries like manufacturing, logistics and distribution. Biosciences are also big sectors here. All of that creates a very diverse economy for our district.
So it's really important for a bank president to understand that there are a lot of different perspectives. You know, what you see depends a lot on where you stand.
So I think the Federal Reserve impacts our community by being willing to listen. It's very important for a state and a community to know that their voice is being heard.
Community feedback that's going to be paramount. So I think making sure that the community feels like they're given a vehicle to give us feedback and talk to us and tell us what they think is important about this job, what they think is going on in the district, and what they think we need to be looking at for the next president of the 10th district.
So if you have anything at all, please share with us. We look forward to hearing from you.